How about we win another one? Four in a row. Let's go, baby.
It is a must-win game for the Anchorage Eagles, and no wonder they're going to the former Cy Young on the mound, Skylar Slabinski, looking to keep his squad alive. The Wolfpack have a 2-1 lead, and here is Game 4 in the Best of 5 World Series. On the other side of things, it'll be the Wolfpack's ace, Hunter Slabinski, looking to win his fourth World Series. Yes, folks, that's right, fourth in a row. And folks, it looks like we have a pitching change. It's Tony Slabinski coming on for the Eagles. Top of the third. Yeah, good take.
Pat
Westrock. All right, how about we win a World Series?
Baby, let's go. Let's make it five.
Presenting the 2024 World Series champs, AWL Wolfpack, Hunter Slabinski, Draft E. Tom Slabinski.
Oh, thank you, man.
Yeah, there we go.
Thank you.
Champs.
Thank you.
Champs.
Great. Champions. Good, man.
Awesome. All right. Yeah. Sign this thing.
Sign it?
Yeah.
All right, man.
Hey, so I like it.
Top your Toms.
Either. Tom, Pat, whatever.
Can't do it. Sorry.
There it is. Alright.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Wolfpack.
Wolfpack.
Hello everybody and welcome to the Whiffle Below Zero podcast, or if you're watching on YouTube, it's the post-game show for the 2024 AWL World Series. Now presenting our two guests, Tony Slabinski, 2023 AWL MVP, and Tom Slabinski, Wolfpack and 2024 champion. What's up, boys? What a year that was. What a year that was. 2024 in the books, Wolfpack undisputed 2024 champs.
Yeah, baby.
All yours,
yeah,
Pat.
Yeah.
I'll start with you, I guess. How does it feel to be on top?
Great. I'm just thankful that Hunter drafted me and that I was on his team because he is an awesome player right here.
I'm happy to have this guy on my team. He helped a whole lot. I mean, he was making contact with the ball series long, even though you robbed him twice. Robbed him twice in one game, two top plays. And it was just a great series overall. I was glad you were able to come up and.
It worked out really well.
Yeah, and overall, great week, good series, and now over here, unfortunately, you're on the other end of things. But how was 2024 for you, with football wise?
Oh, good. I don't think it was my best year, but I feel like you got better, I got worse.
Something like that.
it was good. It was a lot of fun. I'm glad that Hunter allows me to participate in these youthful endeavors.
Yeah, sounds good.
Well, I mean, but at some point, you know, my reign of terror has to come to an end.
Sure.
So, one of these years.
I don't know. It'll have to be soon.
It was just an awesome series. I was glad to be here for it, and I'm glad Hunter drafted me to be on his team. And I hope to be here next year and
defend the title.
Yeah. Do a two-timer. Two-timer.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, all right, thank you, Tom. Thank you, Tom, for joining the pod.
Sure.
There it is. And I guess closing statement from me, glad to be holding the trophy at the end of the year. I mean, definitely most competition this year out of any year. We had a couple new people join the league, and it was definitely a whole lot of fun. And I just want to say, I mean, four times in a row, I'm very proud of this team, very proud of my guys. I think we deserve to be holding the trophy at the end of the year, and it was another huge success. So I want to say thank you to everybody. And I have two shout outs, actually. My first shout out will be to Kalen Slabinski for saying we would never make the World Series.
You think that if I faced a team of Skyler and Tony in the World Series?
No, they were no born. Chance.
No chance for me?
Yeah, no chance.
You're going to make it to the World Series against us?
Not against you. Definitely not you.
Definitely not me. You think that Skyler are going to win?
No! I think Hopi.
You think I'm going to get eliminated and not even make it there?
From Hopi.
And I just want to say, hey, Kalen, what happened? And my second thing is to everybody who's doubting. I mean, we go out there, we put in the work, we have the World Series champion. I mean, people saying they're going to come out here, win every award. I mean, it doesn't happen overnight. It happens with practice. And I think me and Tom definitely have been putting the work in here, around here lately. And
you know, you kind of touched on it, just, you know, the microcosm of the effort that your team put in for the World Series, but I'd like to point out this macro view of the AWL, specifically Hunter's efforts. You know, he has a passion for wiffle ball, and it really has become a thing. You know, now with your first public tournament, you know, obviously multiple seasons that has born out of family league wiffle ball, you know, but now, you know, now you're on to bigger ideas. Like, now that I can't even really, like, put up a fight against you when it comes to wiffle ball. So, like, so now the talks are, oh, is it okay if I talk about this?
Yes.
The talks are about, like, what to do when there's no real competition at your level, at least on this little island that you live on. That, I mean, arguably the whole state. I haven't seen anybody play wiffle ball like Hunter in Alaska. So what do we do about that? What do you do about that is the question. So, you know, so your effort towards your passion is producing fruit, and that's in your skill level, right? Mm-hmm. So if that doesn't continue to be fostered in some way, which, you know, which the public tournament, like hosting and really managing a public tournament is a cool thing, and that is... Yeah, that's a fruit of your efforts and your passion. But as far as your playing, right, you still want to play, you know. So, you know, that's like, I think, the next chapter here.
But AWL 2025 going forward, it's, I mean, next year's going to be interesting. Like, just like he was saying, I mean, it's going to be very interesting to see how this offseason goes and see how big the league is next year. We don't know how many people are leaving, how many people are coming. I'm sure it's going to be more being added to the league than going, but it's going to be definitely the best year yet. So AWL 2025, I can't wait. And as well as my own skill level and improving, my goal for next year is to, you know, try to go professional. I don't know if I'm going to leave this in or not, but I want to be in those big leagues, you know.
Well, that's what the last one more thing was. Y'all out there, anybody who's watching this and in the more well-known leagues should really consider drafting this young person. He's about to hit his prime in the next 2 years of wiffle balling. And again, we have plenty of primary source documentation in proving his skill level to be top notch. So, selling him here to all you major league wiffle ballers or whatever other leagues need a player here. Me being his father and his mother, we're going to support him in getting there somehow. He's a good ball player.
Good game, good series, good season, that was great, thanks.
Once again, everybody, thank you very much for watching. Thank you for tuning in to all of you who've been following the league more closely and watching all these games. It means a whole lot to see those subscriber counts going up. I mean, we've hit a whole lot of milestones this year, from being featured on MLW Wiffle Ball's Pipe It Up podcast, all the way to hitting 100 subscribers and having a public tournament, and even meeting some of you guys. It's been great, and it's only going to get better. We're only going up from here. So without further ado, we'll see you in 2025. Roll the credits.